them, that's all right. It's an off-white, that's all that you rather slash. I do what I have. It's off my Q&A, motherfuckers. It's too hot to be moving around like that. I'm hot as fuck now. Who think I need my ass pumped? Hold up. Make sure you press the bell down next to the subscribe button to be notified every single time that I post a video, because there's been a lot of people telling me that I don't post videos, and I'm just like, y'all fucking crazy. I post videos at least once a week. Y'all just be making me feel like I don't do shit. Talk about, like, there's people that really come up to me like, yo, I love your videos, you don't be posting. I'm like, what? Don't ever disrespect my life like that. I'm an active YouTuber. What up, what up, what up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and it's time for the Q&A, okay? It's time for the Q&A. So, I just hit 2,000 subscribers. Yo, what's good? As a subscriber. So we're gonna start with the questions from Instagram. Blue Iris was my first question. Bruh, Blue Iris, you was one of the realest subscribers I have, like, from day one. You lit. I fucks with you. So she said, which place or country would you like to visit someday? I wanna go to the UK so bad. I wanna go. So I don't think everybody understands. I wanna go to the UK. I wanna develop a English accent. Oh my god. Ooh, I'd be a bad bitch with an English accent. And then I wanna go to Egypt. Oh my goodness. And then my third one would be Australia. I just want the accent. Is that a bad thing? What's the most embarrassing thing you've ever done? I don't understand. Every time I get this type of question, I'm like, I don't really get embarrassed easily, honestly. When I sprained my ankle in high school. First of all, I sprained my ankle playing fucking Foursquare, okay? And y'all know what Foursquare, yeah, that's embarrassing, okay? My roommate fucking laughing at me. It's just not funny. Baseball slash kickball slash, I don't know, dodgeball slash. It's like every gym game you could ever think of, but like in one game. And I was running and I tripped over the fucking mat and sprained the fuck out of my ankle, and I'm laying on the ground and people thinking I'm joking. And even my gym teacher was like, man, Shorty, get up. Like, stop fucking playing. I'm like, yo, I'm dead. Like, I was dead on the ground. And like, yo, my ankle was so disgusting and so swollen. It was like the size of my thigh. Not even joking. It was really big. And yeah, it was just embarrassing. Just the fact that I fell and sprained my ankle over fucking playing Foursquare. Like, I hate telling people that. As you can see, my roommate fucking laughed at me and shit. Fucking asshole. That shit. What you've been listening to the past week? Oh my god, Lil Uzi new mixtape? Yeah. I really can't you cry. I don't really shit never lie. That's the way she let me in. She said I am not afraid to die. On my friends are dead. Listen to the rest. All my friends are dead. Yo. All my friends are dead. Pussy to the head. All my friends are dead. Y'all. All my friends are dead. Pussy to the edge, y'all. That's my shit. And More Life. Drake's More Life is lit. I love it. Who are some of your favorite small YouTubers, and do you think they're more genuine than big YouTubers? Ow! The Kickback. Everybody knows The Kickback is my favorite group of YouTubers. If you don't know who The Kickback is, go down in the description box below and you'll find them. My favorite small YouTuber, wow. Me? Shit. Okay, no, let me get a real answer. Of course, Blue Iris, I fucks with you. So she's one of my favorite. Aside from The Kickback, shit. Deterna, fucks with her, cause she Haitian, you know how I am. I'm biased towards the Haitians. Fluffy Kid. I think that's his name. I love him. Oh my god, I could watch him all day. I need to collab with him. Oh my goodness. Ron Amos. You could be bae. But that's one of my favorite YouTubers as well. But there's a couple more. Let me go down my feed right quick. There's a couple more. Like, every time I see them, I'm like, oh my god. But as for them being more genuine, that's bullshit, actually. And it's funny, honestly, there's fake ass small YouTubers. And to be honest with you, when you really think about it on a deeper level, bigger YouTubers started small. At the end of the day, YouTubers are just people. Celebrities are just people. You know, whether they're assholes or not. They all started somewhere. So one day they were all small and now they're all big. So it's like, I mean, some of them are assholes now. They probably weren't assholes when they were smaller. They actually probably still were assholes when they were smaller, you know? But I think that they're just equally as ain't shit. Fuck. I got 2,000 subscribers and I already feel like I'm the shit. I mean, I guess it all depends. Like, that's an interesting question. I don't think that they're more genuine though, honestly. I feel like smaller YouTubers are just more humbled. That's just the thing. Like, they're not as big as other YouTubers yet. And a lot of them will start to change as soon as the numbers start to hit. Next question. How did you know you wanted to do this as a career? And how did I get started? So, Sun Jacks Hoop. Okay. I knew I wanted to do this because I like to talk. I could talk forever. Okay, this is why I know I want to be a YouTuber and I want to be a radio personality. Like, I want to be paid to be myself. Okay, I want to be paid to talk. That's all I do. Like, I like to talk, I like to entertain, and I like to say shit that people ain't gonna say to entertain motherfuckers. And to open people's minds, you know? A lot of people are so used to doing certain things because they're just used to doing certain things, you know? And I like to do and say things that make people think, you know? Make people not think the way they are raised to think, but think outside of the box and think from other people's perspectives. So when I started realizing, like, that's what I like to do, I was like, yo, maybe I could just keep doing the radio and the YouTube thing, and hopefully it pays off. How did you get started? Well, I answer this question a lot. I'm sure I answered this in a video before, but basically, long story short, I started a YouTube channel years ago, quit twice, which is my third time going, and I'm just here. I mean, like, I just started doing videos one day. Right? It just started. I mean, I don't know. I'm very sure I made a video about this before, so I'm probably gonna cart it or put it down in the description box, or I'll probably be too lazy. And if that does happen, just hit me up. Let's be real, that shit's probably gonna happen. Name a person, either living or dead, you'd want to meet and why. I wanna meet Tupac and I still feel like he in Cuba. That's one. I wanna be Obama because he is bae. Oh my god. Obama cute as hell. Am I the only one that thinks he's cute? I think he is the cutest. Who else do I wanna meet? I wanna meet Drake. Someone take me to Drake, please. Just take me. Like, I love him so much. I'm not even into light skinned men, but Drake can have my whole life. If Drake told me to delete my channel, sorry, fuck all y'all. Time to go. I wanna meet Janelle Monae. Oh my god, I wanna meet Janelle Monae so bad. I like Janelle Monae. I wanna meet her. Felicia Ross, she's a Haitian singer. I wanna meet her too. Oh my god, call him Rennie. Yo. The obsession that I have with Rennie. Rennie, I love him. He is my favorite comedian, and he's Haitian, and he's dark skinned, and he's tall. Oh my god. I'm about to cry. Guys, we can't talk about this right now. We can't talk about my obsession with this man. So, time for the YouTube questions. Oh, call him Rennie. Oh, that's bae. Oh, my head itch. I guess I'm gonna start from the bottom. Oh, wow. There's low-key a lot of questions here. Okay, hopefully my camera doesn't die on y'all at all. Like, oh my god. What are your big accomplishments before you became a YouTuber? And I love you so much. Aw, thank you, Inez. Love, Inez. I think I'm saying that right. I love y'all so much, bitch. Biggest accomplishments before YouTube. Graduating high school, I guess. I mean, I really don't see that as an accomplishment, but a lot of people, I guess, can see that as an accomplishment. I saw that. Shut up. I saw that as, I see me graduating high school as an accomplishment, kind of, because a lot of people don't graduate high school. But realistically, I feel like that's just something I had to do. Also, honestly, YouTube is one of my biggest accomplishments. Like, I stuck to something. To be honest with you, like, I start a lot of shit and don't finish it. I'm one of those people. Even water. Shit, I drink a half a water bottle and I open another one. Like, I don't know why I have that habit, but I don't really stick to things. So this has to be one of my biggest accomplishments. I'm about to graduate college, so that's gonna be another really big accomplishment. Next one, do you plan on having a relationship anytime soon? Well, I am talking to someone and he watches my videos, so he knows who he is. But I don't know. Yeah, time will tell. Where do you picture yourself in 10 years?
Okay, so I wanna be a full-time YouTuber, a radio personality, and I also wanna have my own public relations company that deals with the promotion of content creators.
Do you have any type of regrets at the moment?
The only regret I would say that I have is not doing videos throughout my college career. I started back my YouTube channel the summer of my sophomore year, and I still wasn't really consistent until like the second semester of my junior year. I really wish that I kept vlogging, and I really wish that I kept doing videos throughout my college career so at least I could see my growth. And I think it could have been like real interesting to you guys just to watch that as well. Describe your most ultimate vacation home.
I want to vacation on one of those like houses that's like kind of like in a jungle type setting, but like kind of, maybe I'm gonna insert a photo right here. I want one of these, just look at this picture. I'm gonna find a picture and I'm gonna put it right here. What's your dream job? YouTube, Ron Amos, you're so cute. Anyways, that's my dream job. I wanna be a radio personality and a YouTube person. Like, I just wanna wake up, make YouTube videos, and then go to my radio personality job. And I shall hit this in the next 7 years. Yes, I gave myself 7 years. Would you ever have a meet and greet? Maybe in the future, but I don't think I even have enough subscribers to be having anybody meet and greet. That shit would not work out. Maybe when I hit like 20,000 or 50,000, I'll have a meet and greet, but let's see when that happens. What are your favorite YouTubers? Is it The Real Addy? I like him a lot, and he look good. Addicted Addy, I think that's his new name. Yep, Addicted Addy. Love him. That is bae. I fucks with him. I really like him. It's Baby J. Love her. Kendall Ray. Who else? Ooh! Hey Paris. Watch her religiously. Let me just go down my notification box. Oh, John Cookian. I love Cookian. That's where I get all my drama from, y'all. I have a lot of them. I have a lot of really favorite YouTubers. Jordan Cheyenne. I really like her too. She's a really good YouTuber. Allie Hurdisty. Bugatti Bees. I'm getting married to Bugatti Bees. Damn, y'all, I'm a thought. Didn't I say I was getting married to somebody and I love somebody like 4 times in this video already? I still love Simply Nessa. I know a lot of people do not like her. I love her. Simply Nessa, fuck out of here. She's lit. She's lit, okay? These questions are a lot and my camera's about to fucking die on me. Beef patties or curry chicken? Beef patties. Have you ever fought someone? You ain't seen one of my story times. I have a whole story time of how I got jumped before. I need to tell some of my fight stories. That would be an interesting one. Thank you for giving me some ideas. But if you want to see the time I got jumped, right here or down there. Would you ever do a social experiment? I actually always wanted to do those, but I have really bad luck. And I'll fuck around and something really bad will happen. I'll fuck around and go to jail for it. So no. Mm-mm. Do you like Trump? Fuck Donald Trump. Fake ice cream flavor. Vanilla and cake batter. I love cake batter. Would you rather stink and not be able to smell it or smell something horrible everyone can't smell? I'd rather be able to stink. All y'all motherfuckers gonna suffer. Fuck it. I don't know. I have a really strong sense of smell, so I don't want to smell anything nasty. Mm-mm. What do you think about Drake's new album? Kaya. It's not an album. It's a playlist. Shit is lit, yo. Oh my god. Do you plan on going to Haiti in a few years on vacation? Yes, I do. In the next 3 years or so. How's the radio show going? Going very well, for the exception that I just got told that my work was incredible and unprofessional by a professor of mine. But it's going very well. I love radio. Like, that's my next love next to YouTube. Radio and YouTube, love it so fucking much. Congrats on making it to 2K, lady. So proud of you. I hope to get there someday. My question for you is, what inspired you to do YouTube? Also, what's your opinion on online dating? Do you think it's a good idea or a waste of time? Thank you. You will definitely get there. And yeah, what inspired me to YouTube? I really fucking made a video about this, y'all. Y'all making me feel like I'm posting videos for no reason. I definitely will put it up in the card or down below, because now that's like the second person to ask me that. Online dating. Oh, hang on, online dating. I think
it's okay. I've online dated people in the past and it's worked out fine. I think it's okay as long as you know who the person is and you're not these stupid ass motherfuckers on Catfish. As long as you know who the person is, you actually conversate with them, you actually meet up with them, you actually like go places with them, like in the long run, and you actually like find out who they are and you're not stupid and it's not like one of those situations like Catfish where it's like, oh my god, I don't know what they look like, they refuse to FaceTime me, then I think it's perfectly fine. What is your deepest regret in life? Did somebody ask me that? Yeah, someone definitely did. Do I have any regrets at the moment? That was a question. Honestly, like I said before, my biggest regret is really just not sticking to my YouTube channel the first two times that I fucking quit. That's the only real regret I really have. How do you balance being a college student and being an active YouTuber considering a good amount of YouTubers are in school? Honestly, at the end of the day, if you really want to do something, you're going to do it. You will never make excuses for something that you really want to do. And it really bothers me when people tell me that the reason that they don't post on YouTube is because they're busy. That's absolute bullshit. Because at the end of the day, we're all busy, okay? And I always am a firm believer of the fact that no one is ever long-term busy, okay? Like right now, this is me being busy. But if you ever hit me up and you're like, damn, sure, you ain't hit me up in a whole month, I can't be like, oh man, I was busy. Bitch, and that whole entire month, there was a fucking time for me to hit you up, okay? There was time for like us to conversate. It's the same thing with YouTube. You can find time to do it, okay? You can find time to record, you can find time to edit. You can edit on the go, you could, you know, just record a shit ton of videos and then edit as you go. But the fact that people really sit there like, oh man, I'm busy, that's why I can't do this. I'm busy, that's why I can't do that. That's such bullshit to me. Like, I find that as an excuse. So honestly, it's all about priorities. So I prioritize everything. Like I do my schoolwork and then I do my videos. And then like as days go by, I just edit and I put them up as, you know, yeah, as life progresses. Would you make one video with both of your parents? Oh, that's interesting. My mother, I could probably get to do it. My father's not doing that shit for nobody, y'all. Mm-mm. Haitian parents, man. I wonder what happened to the girl who bought you the nasty Thanksgiving food. Are y'all still friends? Actually, we're still cool as hell, but I don't get to see her like that anymore because she moved. So yeah, we're still cool though. Thank God she didn't know that video was about her. I mean, I don't really give a shit. What advice could you give me because I asked my crush to prom on Friday and he basically rejected me and I couldn't stop crying, but I really like him and I don't know if I should talk to him like normal or just ignore him. By the way, you're my favorite YouTuber and you're beautiful. I love you. Thank you. That was so cute. I'm gonna cry. That was so sweet. Thank you. First of all, it's prom, which means it's high school, which means he ain't shit and he's not gonna be relevant to you in the next 4 years, so fuck him. Next, talk to him like normal. Honestly, if you're not comfortable to talk to him, don't talk to him. It is what it is. Like, you don't have to talk to anyone you're not comfortable talking to. At the end of the day, like, that's, fuck it. Like, if he's mad about that, then he's mad about it. If you don't want to fuck with him, don't fuck with him. But honestly, I would say talk to him like normal. I mean, if you're comfortable with it, it all depends on what you're comfortable with. I should start a damn advice column. People be asking me for advice. Don't be asking me these types of questions on Q&A. This is kind of personal. So my camera is about to die, and thankfully, that was my last question. Thank you so much for helping me reach 2,000 subscribers. I'm so happy and I'm so grateful to have all of you guys. I just might cry. Like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'ma see y'all.